Hi. Hi, I'm Mark, and I go to Westside Middle School.
Disturb the silence!
My poem draws inspiration from the visions I sometimes have and the writings of Edgar Allan Poe. It's called Split Visions. What I'm about to tell you is lunacy. I say Luna, for that is my friend's name, and the acute visions came first to her. The abstruse truth is that they manifest from each touch of a certain stone. Then one cold January night, she presented me with that ill-fated pebble, a most egregious and unwelcome gift. For with my first touch, the visions, that twisted eyesight, contorted me into a fight against my will, a brawl to keep the little sanity I had left, engulfing me into the shape-shifting murkiness of the hellish otherworld. You should have known how I eluded, with what momentum, with what terror, that inhospitable terrain. But I was like a child enticed with candy, unable to resist the lure of the forbidden. From the mist there emerged a figure dressed in skin-tight black. Her unforgiving smile revealed the tongue, and long, as thick as an eel with a haunting curl at the end. She gesticulated wildly, her tongue darting, flowing like a waterfall, testing the air. Then she morphed into a red wisp and absorbed herself into me. When at last my focus returned, I saw myself on an ancient leather couch, healing scars athwart my wrists, vanta black bags under my eyes, my wits eaten away by insomnia, leaving me a mere relic of my former self. A black cat perched on the edge of a coffee table, eyeing me slantwise, cocking his head first to the right, then to the left. Desperate for help, I clutched my phone from the table, but its minuscule weight was more than my feeble fingers could manage, and my hands, now as heavy as anchor, sunk to the floor. Then darkness surrounded me. Darkness, cold, and nothing more. I'm seated alone in a crowded restaurant. Muted screams and sobs absorbed themselves into my ears, where there had once been a wall. Now there was nothing. The cold, haunting, chilling, and terrifying flowed in an unstoppable stream. All heads turned, revealing their chilling visages, each with one button eye and the other of solid black, their mouths sewn shut with moldy string. Then appeared a girl, her face one familiar yet unrecognizable. Her fearful giggle formed me in the sense of pure dread, as from her hair she produced a bloodstained needle. "Eye or mouth," she cackled. I tried to scream, but no sound did I make. Then solitude surrounded me. Solitude, cold, and nothing more. Then I saw myself standing, straitjacketed in a padded cell. The torture master's eyes seared the phosphorized glass of the one-way mirror, but the face in the reflection was of my own. I opened my mouth to scream, but instead of sound, black blood sprayed forth, twisting and twirling toward that demented portal, shattering the glass, revealing a figure dressed in skin-tight black. Again, she gesticulated, her tongue asserting dominance. Then slowly, she decamped into a strange, misty, liquid crimson, taking with her the hellish otherworld and leaving me alone with the haunted rock that started it all.
Oh, yes.